Impressed? I sure am. But there are a few things happening here that you probably don't notice. And they have to do with forces and motion.
By pushing off down the ramp, this skateboarder gains momentum, picking up speed. This allows the skateboarder to make it up the opposite ramp and perform a trick.
Smooth surfaces along both the rail and bottom of the skateboard make this trick possible.
Imagine if these surfaces weren't smooth. This trick might result in a trip to the hospital.
It turns out forces and motion play an active role in our daily lives.
Okay, so forces are like pushes and pulls. And a push or pull can get something moving, or it can stop something from moving. So it can change its motion. So if we tug on something one way, tug the other way, tug a little harder this way, it's going to start moving that way, right? Or it's going to move faster and faster. Got two things, they rub together. They stick a little bit, all right? And that can cause a force. If I've got a block sliding down a ramp, it can stick a little bit to that ramp, and that keeps it from speeding up as much as it might. I hold the ball, it drops, right? So we got a really big Earth, and it turns out that Earth can tug on things. In fact, it turns out that anything can tug on anything else, but really the Earth's the real big thing here. So when we drop stuff, it falls towards the Earth. Realistically, yeah, anything can be made to move, but it can be really hard to make really big things or things that are really stuck move. If that really heavy table in the middle of the room is stuck so hard to the floor that we can't push hard enough, then we're not gonna change its motion. We're not gonna speed it up. We're not gonna make it move. If something's bolted down to the floor or bolted to the wall, we'd have to tug hard enough to like break those bolts off to fight that force to change its motion to make it move.
While skateboarding is fun, there's a safer way to test forces of motion that will allow us to gather data and better understand how they work.
And it's still pretty fun, too. We've created our own ramp with wood and objects we found laying around. Sandpaper, carpet, aluminum foil, and wood.
But it doesn't need to be that fancy. We made this one with cardboard and tape and the same materials.
No matter how you decide to build your ramp, don't forget the dividers so that the objects stay in their own lanes. Once you have your ramp made, start to experiment with force and motion. Find as many different objects as you can. Describe those objects. Sort them by size, shape, weight, whether or not they roll.
Send those objects down your ramp and observe what happens. How do different surfaces affect different objects? How do the objects move down the ramp? What does changing the height of the ramp do?
What other ways do force and motion affect us every day?
You're running out to the playground. Every time you push on the ground pushes back on you. That helps you move. You jump up and you grab the bars and you hang there. The earth's tugging down and the bars are tugging up on you. If you pull up a little harder, you move up. If you throw the ball, you're exerting a force on the ball and then the earth tries to pull it back down to the ground. So forces are just everywhere. Everything that's either sitting still or moving, anytime it changes, there's been a set of forces that didn't quite balance out and make you go faster, make you go slower, zigzag, change your direction, things like that.
I think it's safe to say that forces in motion play a major role in our daily lives.
And now that you have your own way to explore and test in countless ways, it's time to get out there and do it yourself.